maid. She was very sweet. She was ever so proud of every one of her 100 feet. Early every morning, her neighbors came to glance. She always entertained them with a beautiful little dance. As leg number 94 gave 95 a shunt, legs number 1 and 2 were twisting out in front. As legs number 9 and 10 went wriggling up the side, 73 and 74 were doing the pally glide. Knew her neighbour Jenny Longlegs with jealousy was mad. She went out and bought herself a pencil and a pad. She came a month of mornings and made a careful note of every step the centipede made, and this is what she wrote. As leg number 94 gave 95 a shunt, legs number 1 and 2 were twisting out in front. As legs number 9 and 10 went wriggling up the side, 73 and 74 were doing the pally glide. And with exact notation, young Jenny Longlegs tried to dance just like the centipede. She failed and nearly cried. She grabbed hold of the centipede and said, "Now have a look and show me how you do these steps I've written in my book." Said the centipede, "Do I do that?" She tried to demonstrate. She'd never thought of a thing before, and she didn't do too great. Her 100 legs got twisted and she wound up in a fangle. She fractured 14 shin bones, 13 kneecaps and an ankle. As leg number 1 and 2 got tied with 3 and 4, legs number 5 and 6 got trampled on the floor. Leg number 70 was attacked by number 10. 98 and 99 will never dance again. Though the wee Kikubri centipede, she suffered a terrible pain. All of us were very surprised the day she danced again. So now she tells her neighbours, everyone who comes to see, never try an explanation of what comes naturally. As leg number 94 gave 95 a shunt, legs number 1 and 2 were twisting out in front. As legs number 9 and 10 went wriggling up the side, 73 and 70.